I do want to get to Syria, and this is where we'll leave you here. Some news out of Syria to share with you first, though, here at home. The crisis in Syria becoming an issue in the presidential campaign. We heard Mitt Romney sounding off about this just this morning.
With regards to Syria, what did he say about Syria, his administration say about Syria's Assad? He said he was a reformer. Assad, a reformer? Really? As he's murdering his own people?
Quick fact check. The Obama administration says Syrian President Bashar al-Assad fits the definition of a war criminal and not a reformer. Be that as it may, it is becoming an issue, and I want you to hold that thought because I want to go to CNN's senior international correspondent Nick Robertson for us in Syria's, of course, southern neighbor Lebanon. And Nick, I understand there are several major developments today in the besieged Syrian city of Homs and in the neighborhood there known as Bab al-Amir. Tell me what's happening.
Yeah, the most significant thing is that the Free Syrian Army have done what they've called a tactical withdrawal. They pulled out of the Bab al-Amir neighborhood of Homs. They say they're running out of ammunition, running out of weapons, and they didn't want to put the civilians there in any more harm's way. They've pulled out, leaving about 5,000 civilians. But it doesn't matter which way you put the language here. They were beaten out by Assad's forces. Bigger, better organized, more military equipment, helicopter gunships yesterday, tanks on the streets yesterday. It's been going on for a month, and now the Free Syrian Army finally defeated, beaten out of Bab al-Amir. And now the concern is what happens to the rest of the people. Their activists already saying government forces in there, going house to house, taking away any men over 12 years old. We're talking about young boys here as well, Brooke.
Concerns about the civilians, also concerns about potentially arming the rebels. Should we arm them or not is one of the questions. I want you to listen to some sound. This is Secretary of State Hillary Clinton. She was testifying just yesterday.
When Zawahiri of al-Qaeda comes out and supports the Syrian opposition, you got to ask yourself, if we arm, who are we arming? And how would we get the arms in there? And what good would automatic weapons against artillery and tanks do?
It was a similar question I know we asked when it came to the opposition in Libya. I mean, to her earlier point, are we getting any better picture now of who these rebels are?
We are getting a slightly better picture. You're getting a picture that's varied. In Homs, for example, people describe there being a sort of, if you like, a better educated, more sophisticated, more secular type of Free Syrian Army fighter. In other parts of the country, more rural areas, a lot of them are more conservative. There have even been videos released in the last week by groups that look very much like al-Qaeda in Iraq, operating under a different name. U.S. officials say small numbers of al-Qaeda in Iraq are making their way to the fight in Syria. We've seen suicide bombings that they're believed to have been behind. Certainly that's what this latest video shows, a suicide bombing. So there are elements of al-Qaeda in Iraq there.
Even though dozens were killed in fighting across Syria today, the United Nations new special envoy, the former Secretary General Kofi Annan, cautioned that outside military intervention could, he said, make the crisis even worse. Also today, Secretary of State Hillary Clinton said the United States is trying to help unify the opponents of the Syrian president, Bashar al-Assad.
We are working closely with the Syrian opposition to try to assist them be able to present that kind of unified front and resolve that I know they feel on their own behalf is essential in this struggle against the brutal Assad regime.
Well, a special United Nations meeting has so far failed to find a way to stop the violence in Syria. Secretary of State Hillary Clinton met with Russia's foreign minister and other diplomats yesterday to talk about a potential ceasefire. Russia, Syria's most powerful ally, has vetoed two Security Council resolutions, which would have condemned the crackdown in Syria. Mrs. Clinton said that the Security Council cannot, quote, stand silent when governments attack their own people. Opposition forces say government soldiers rounded up civilians in the city of Homs and killed dozens of people yesterday. The UN says more than 7,500 people have died in the fighting in Syria over the last year. Syrian troops continued attacks on opposition forces yesterday, but the UN's Kofi Annan insists Syria will respect the ceasefire. They say they'll respect it starting tomorrow. U.S. Secretary of State Hillary Clinton says Syria is now becoming a regional security issue.
And you just led, just a while ago, you spoke about Secretary of State Hillary Clinton questioning whether Mitt Romney could win or lose. That is not the task of a Secretary of State. She should be paying attention to the rebellion in Syria, and we have to accept that we have, the United States has in many ways been the force that has been holding back arming the Syrian defectors.
Yeah, she was, in fairness to the Secretary of State, she was asked about Mitt Romney's statements that Russia is now the geopolitical major foe of the United States. She answered that without getting into politics. Her husband, the former president, was certainly open to talking about politics much more so, and we're going to have much more in this part of the story later.
Concerns about the civilians, also concerns about potentially arming the rebels. Should we arm them or not is one of the questions. I want you to listen to some sound. This is Secretary of State Hillary Clinton. She was testifying just yesterday.
When Zawahiri of Al-Qaeda comes out and supports the Syrian opposition, you got to ask yourself, if we arm, who are we arming? And how would we get the arms in there? And what good would automatic weapons against artillery and tanks do?
It was a similar question I know we asked when it came to the opposition in Libya. I mean, to her earlier point, are we getting any better picture now of who these rebels are?
Secretary of State Hillary Clinton takes an unusual dip a little bit into political waters. Just ahead, you're going to want to hear what the Secretary of State is saying about Republican presidential frontrunner Mitt Romney. She's suggesting he may be, quote, out of touch. And former President Bill Clinton and his wife, the Secretary of State Hillary Clinton, they're both piling on Mitt Romney, saying the GOP presidential frontrunner is, quote, out of touch and can't win the race. Republican presidential frontrunner Mitt Romney is getting hit hard from the left by not just one, but two Clintons at the same time. The Secretary of State Hillary Clinton typically doesn't wade into political waters, but made an exception when our own foreign affairs correspondent Jill Doherty asked her about a controversial comment Romney made right here in the Situation Room, calling Russia, and I'm quoting Romney now, our number one geopolitical foe.
I think it's somewhat dated to be looking backwards instead of being realistic about where we agree, where we don't agree.
Her husband, the former President Bill Clinton, insists Romney could be in serious trouble, suggesting to ABC News this race is very different from his own successful run back in 1992.
Mine was just one long character attack, but we never had to change what we were saying from the primary to the general.
We're gonna let this guy do it.
The problem that Governor Romney has is his character attack was, you don't really know what he believes. He did this, he says that.
When asked about a potential White House run for Hillary Clinton in 2016, a doting Bill Clinton simply said this.
I miss her. We have fun together. She wants to come home and decompress and relax. And I believe that she's being absolutely honest with you when she says she doesn't think she'll go back into politics. But if she comes home and we do this foundation stuff for the rest of our lives, I'll be happy. If she changes her mind and decides to run, I'll be happy.
He's going to be happy either way. Let's talk about this dual Clinton swap at Mitt Romney. Joining us, our chief political analyst, Gloria Borger. Very different tones to a certain degree. He's much more political than Hillary Clinton is, but they're both going after Mitt Romney. I guess they both think he's the presumptive Republican nominee.
And it's very powerful, first of all, coming from Hillary Clinton, who's probably one of the most popular women in this country, certainly one of the most respected women around the world. And she just responded to a question about Mitt Romney and Russia, foreign policy, and that's her job as Secretary of State. But she is, of course, political. And Bill Clinton makes a very good point, which is that Mitt Romney's character flaw, if you will, is the question of what's at his core, what does he really believe in? And Bill Clinton makes a point, you know, his character flaw was about something else, yeah, which of course he didn't talk about.
Because, you know, Bill Clinton successfully in 92 defeated an incumbent president, a sitting president, George H.W. Bush, mm-hmm. and Romney's trying to do the same thing right now. What Bill Clinton was saying, you know what, he probably doesn't have the wherewithal. I did, he says, but Romney doesn't.
Well, the interesting thing about Bill Clinton, if you recall, is that he was a Southern moderate governor who decided he wanted to take the Democratic Party in a different direction. With Mitt Romney, you see someone who seems to be following the lead of where the Republican Party is heading. He had been a more moderate Republican governor in the state of Massachusetts. Now the Republican Party has become much more conservative. So you can make the case that instead of leading the party in a certain direction, he's actually trying to figure out where it's going and following.
What's interesting about Hillary Clinton, she seems to suggest that after she gives up her job as Secretary of State, she's finished with politics, no more politics. But you just heard her husband leave that door pretty wide open if that's what she wants to do.
Have you ever heard of transference, Wolf, where maybe Bill Clinton would like another shot at being president?
I'm sure he would.
I believe Hillary Clinton. I think she's exhausted. I think it's a job that takes so much time and travel and energy if you do it the right way. And most people would agree she is doing it the right way and that she does want to take time to reflect. Of course, she can't predict what's going to happen in 2016. If she were to decide that she were interested in the nomination in 2016, I think you'd have to say she'd be an automatic front runner, although I guess Joe Biden might be in that race too, so you'd have
Andrew Cuomo,
Martin O'Malley,
there are a whole bunch of Democrats.
Well, and then you'd have a real generational issue in the Democratic Party as you have in the Republican Party right
now. She'll be, 68 or 69 years old in 4 years, so still a relatively young woman. She could take a month off, relax a little bit, and then go back into politics.
Take a month off, sure.
That's not bad. Thanks very much, Claire.
To Hillary Clinton, keep fighting for us.
TeamHillaryClinton.com.